a United Nations mandate. It was enacted October 2010, and it calls for everyone of faith and goodwill to come together the first week of February and engage in activities very much like you see here tonight. In the 3 years that we've done it, we have grown and we have attracted the kinds of partners that you need to bring off a very, very good weekend. I'm very, very pleased to announce to everyone that Toronto, our activities in Toronto were recognized by King Abdullah II of Jordan and his World Interfaith Harmony Week Committee as placing third in the world out of 900 events. What that allowed was members of our committee were able to travel to Jordan and receive from His Majesty the King a medal, which I really couldn't duplicate for you tonight, Dr. Sleamy. They gave us a check that I really couldn't duplicate, because that would be fraud. But I'm pleased to announce that we did win almost $6,000 Canadian, which we will be putting back into interfaith work and World Interfaith Harmony Week, so that's really good. And one thing that I could duplicate was what was received from His Majesty. It's an award plaque that I'd like to present to Dr. Sleamy and his Canadian Center. And I'm also very, very happy to announce that I was able to do the same thing to IDI last month, because they had another wonderful event, and World Interfaith Harmony Week would not be able to be as good as it is without people like Dr. Sleamy and the IDI Institute putting on these wonderful events with us. So thank you very, very much. And I'm very pleased.